Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Spyro the Dragon. First thing I'm going to ask you, are you guys ready to get wild? Because we're doing wild flight this area. And then from there, probably the treetops. Wild flight is, considering the targets here, they get you a lot of time, and that makes the area a little easier, and I just missed a boat there, which is an epic fail on my part. I just missed another one because I suck. But they give you tons of time, and the boats give you 3, but the big issue is really the low altitude flying. You see, I'm skimming the water right now. The upside of this is obviously speed, but the downside is kind of obvious. You hit water, run over. See if I can try to chain these. That'd be awesome. If I could! Fuck! Cock! Alright. Once more! With feeling! I'm pissed! I mean, the last time I went, I had a scrap recording of this, and it worked perfectly in my favor! I freaking beasted. Now I want to go back to beasting. Beasting and feasting, that's what it's about. I sound like Clyde Frazier when I said that. For whatever reason, just slicing and dicing, slashing and dashing, and I go up with that. Whatever I just said, I forgot what I said already. But you want to get the arches in the boats, because you can get them in one fell swoop. What you can also get is the chests and the, planes kind of in a fell swoop, but not as easily. So that's kind of what I'm trying to do. See if I can get a really quick time. I told you, I'm trying to get sub a minute on one of these. This might not be the one I'll do it in, but I really want to do it. And right now, I am beasting this area of the yin-yang! Woohoo! 27.3! That's even better than my scrap recording! My scrap recording, I got 21 seconds at the 109! Nice! That is beasting the area. I don't care what none of y'all say. So, I'm very satisfied with that. I don't think wild flight I can cut under a minute, but the next one I might be able to. So, let's go to treetops now. Look at the back! Look at the back! Are those wings? Look at that! Guys, we learned something today! Pigs can fly! They have tiny little wings on their backs! I did not notice that. They're so tiny, though, they really can't get off the ground, so maybe pigs can't fly. I don't know any pig out there that has wings, do you? Oh, that reminds me of a joke. It's kind of a political joke, so I'll spare the political part of it, but they talked about a joke where said something will happen when something happens when pigs can fly. And then we had the swine flu. Which I got afflicted by, I think. So, my senior year of college, I got afflicted with the flu when I got sent home. That was around the swine flu scare, so I'm wondering if I had that or not. I think I mentioned that before, but if I didn't, now you know. Now, we don't want to go this way yet, because there's a locked chest over there, so we need the key. So the key is over here, actually. You already saw all the areas for this level. You got these giant orangutans right here, which will try to kick you. And you have these small guys right here that'll shoot banana bunches at you. Oddly enough, I don't think you can charge through the bananas. Through the banana things. Just something to point out, I don't think you can. If you notice too, with this area, doesn't the music sound kind of familiar to you? It should, because it's exactly the same as High Caves. I'm sure you remember what that was like. The first supercharged level? Well, this is the granddaddy of the supercharged levels. This is the type of supercharged level that they basically took off the training wheels for this. Now, you saw those two thieves, the two thieves earlier. I mean, you saw the purple one, which was on the other side, standing right near the that platform, which I forewent for now. And you saw the yellow one in the beginning. Well, these guys are gem thieves, but you won't be able to find them until you access very tough areas. Well, I'll show you both of them, obviously. I know what to do for both, but That's the reason I called it 100% run.
Greetings, Spyro. For an amazing tour of the treetops, don't just stop at one supercharge.
That guy's a really thick bayou dialect. I don't have a problem with it. I kind of like it. All right. Now, first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a dry glide right through towards the end, picking up everything I can in sight. Holy extreme, Batman, that was too close. I probably should have thought of that before I did it. I nearly just cost myself my perfect run there. Like, I came damn close to it. Now, let's jump over here and we're going to just finish this up. And take out this strong box, yes! Awesomeness. Take out that orangutan, and now we just jump over here. And up there is one of those thieves. That's the easier one to get. That requires, like, maybe a linking. Yes, you're going to be doing the linking of three ramps, I want to say, and the other one is, like, five or six. It's retarded. So I want to wait for that. Now that we did that and we got the key, I'm going to go back to, the other dragon platform. But first... Oh! No! Perfect one! Edging on an enemy that's not even... No! Okay, guys, like I said, one hit, one death. Besides, you guys are waiting for him for a long while. I'm sure you guys are bored as heck, I'm sure. I can't believe I did that. You know, I was expecting to die... Since I made it through Terrace Village and Misty Bog so well, I was expecting I would take my first hit on one of the next worlds. But unfortunately, it's ended. My perfect run has ended. Nice knowing you! As promised. Screw you, monkeys! I hate monkeys now! Monkey season! It's monkey season! It's monkey season! It's monkey season now! Can't throw stuff through walls, bitch! That's it! Monkey season! Scorched Earth policy! Monkey season! Scorched Earth policy! I've had it with monkeys! I'm gonna go ape shit on the monkeys! Ape shit time on you guys, you some bitches! Go off the edge! I hope you're rotten decay! I hope you're rotten hell! Ah, you sons of bitches. This is gonna piss me off. I am so pissed right now. You ended my perfect match, and now you're going to pay for it. My name is Diego Montoya. You killed my first Spyro. Prepare to die, motherfucker! Yes, I'm taking this pretty hard. You can't tell already. I'm kind of embarrassed I took a hit there. I'm very pissed. Maybe I should set up the counter and everything. I've been putting off the counter for how long, I'm not sure, but now I can't put it off any longer. Okay. Well, since that ended, it was a good run while it lasted. But, back over here. Now we gotta take on these orangutans. Like I said, the enemies are not hard at all. I just fucked up because I got a little happy. Alright, good, I kept the key. That's what I wanted. Make sure I kept the key. Alright, yeah, I kinda just lost my edge there. That is... I just feel a little down now.
Spyro, if you jump at the end of a supercharge ramp, you can really go far.
I'm all over.
Then again, I had a couple brushes with death already in this level, so I guess, yeah. Maybe it was just meant to happen. Well, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this thing right here. I'm gonna go right through the supercharge thing just so I can say I did it. Now, I'll meet you guys back over at that same ramp that we were just at. Okay. And for any of you say anything about asking me if I died, I took care of all the enemies. Of course I wouldn't have died from them. Alright, what I'm supposed to do is I'm supposed to jump over here. take this on the way up, and you'll notice there's a little ramp right at the end of here. You want to launch off this, jump over here, jump over this thing, take this ramp right here, and launch! Nan-nan to yourself, bitch. Okay, that's one of the things to do. Now it's time for the other thing, and this one right here is fucking convoluted as shit. How convoluted is this? Well, let's put it this way. You never would have figured this out first time around. Trust me on that. Never would have. You want to know how I figured this out? I used to subscribe to this thing called PlayStation Underground way back in the day, at least a decade ago. Yeah, a decade ago. And in this was a, they would show you, like, games that are about to be released and whatnot. That's how I got to play Spyro the Dragon. Originally played the demo version of it. I got to play, like, some other games that I later bought. I got to play Legend Dragoon. Legend Dragoon's another one. Played a bunch of other games. So, yeah. They also did videos and stuff. They also had behind-the-scenes shit, too. And one of them was Spyro the Dragon. And during the behind-the-scenes vid, they showed this. They showed what you're supposed to do here. I'm telling you, convoluted as shit. Ready? Here's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to take this ramp down, launch off here, take the northeastern thing, that'd be this one, launch off this ramp right here, jump up, take a huge right, go up this ramp, jump here, and then take this one and launch, and hope you have enough to make it. Very close. But it made it, so, I guess, yeah. And there we go. That is 500, and now we gotta rescue this dragon right here, and that can start at the end of it. Jed.
That was quite a ride, Spyro.
Say that again.
You've learned a lot since you were a young glider.
Yeah, well, you could have found an easier spot to get stuck.
What exactly were you doing out here anyway, meditating? Maybe Jed was meditating, I'm not sure. But either way, that was the end of that little area. I'm so pissed I got hit. I am so pissed, guys. I'm able to shake it off right now and just, you know, say, you know, kind of stay casual, kind of stay composed and casual and whatnot. And not, you know, flip out like some other Let's Players probably would be doing if they were doing this type of run. But, yeah. I'm a little pissed. But that's kind of it. I mean, 503 dragons? We're leaving the treetops. So, next time on Spyro the Dragon, with my perfect streak ended, officially, we head off to Metalhead. See you guys then.